Hi, welcome to Root Access, the show on Google Developers Live about startups. My name is Martin Omander, and I'm joined here today by Dawn Dodge, Googler, longtime investor and startup evangelist. We're going to have a series of discussions about new hot technologies, and today we're going to talk about indoor location. Dawn, you've invested in indoor location startups. There have been some recent acquisitions. What's this indoor location all about? What are the use cases?
Yeah, so indoor location has gotten a lot of attention recently because there have been three high-profile acquisitions in this space. Apple acquired Wi-Fi Slam, Ruckus Networks acquired one, and there was a third one that was acquired. So it's getting a lot of attention from investors and technologists about, hey, what's going on here? What's going on is because of the emergence of smartphones, everyone has a computer in their pocket that's capable of displaying a map, and it has a built-in GPS and a built-in Wi-Fi and a built-in Bluetooth. Those technologies can be used to locate you indoors. So GPS and maps work great outdoors, but we spend 90% of our time indoors. So inside an office building, inside a shopping mall, inside a college dorm or wherever, GPS doesn't work. So maps don't help. And these indoor location technologies do work indoors and open up all sorts of opportunities. So that's why it's a hot trend right now.
Ah, right. So that's why we're seeing it now and not 5 years ago, because we all have smartphones?
Right. The technology has been around for a while, but the ability to use it really depends on the smartphone and the built-in sensors in the smartphone, the Wi-Fi radios and Bluetooth and GPS. All of those things together make it possible to be able to do indoor location with technologies that have been around for a while.
So I know what building I'm in. I entered by the front door here today. How can knowing exactly where in the building I am help me or others around me?
Well, first, how would it work? So there would be a little sensor on the front door when you enter. So that's what's known as a truth point. From that truth point, you can use a variety of technologies to determine where you are in the building. So it could use the accelerometer or the gyro or the compass or other sensors that are built into your phone to count the steps and direction from that known truth point. Or when you enter the building, it has Wi-Fi. So your smartphone picks up the Wi-Fi signals and can triangulate from those signals where you are in the building. Mm. Or it could use Bluetooth low energy type beacons that are on the wall or in the ceiling to help navigate where you are. Another approach is something called Byte Light. It uses LED lights that pulse. And the pulses in those lights are so fast the human eye can't see them. But when you're holding your smartphone in your hand, there's a front-facing camera. That camera picks up the pulses and can identify which light is emitting that pulse and therefore triangulate where you are. So that's a quick overview of some of the technologies that are used and how they work. But now that you know how they work, mm-hmm. how would a user use them, or what applications of this technology are there? Well, the obvious ones are things like retailers and supermarkets and that sort of thing. Let's say you have a shopping list for the grocery store and it has 30 items on it. If you're like me, you've gone through the store and you get 27 of the 30 items, and then you have to backtrack to find the last three. Like, where are they? You somehow missed them.
Been there, done that, yes.
So you could use this to put your shopping list in your phone, and then the phone would create a map for you and tell you exactly where each of those products are on the shelf. Or if you're in a retail location like Walmart or Lowe's or Walgreens, where they have thousands of SKUs, you could do a search for, tell me where the Gucci bags are, or tell me where the spaghetti is, and it will take you right to that point. So you could use them those ways. Social applications. You want to know where your friends are. you're at a concert or you're at a conference with 5,000 people, and you know you have 10 friends there, but where are they? You can't find them. Well, with indoor location, you can type in the name of that friend, they accept that they want to you to be able to know where they are, and then boom, on the map it shows you exactly where they are. Or if you take your family to the shopping mall and your kids are running off in other directions and you go this way and the spouse goes the other way, on a map you can actually see where you are. So there are all kinds of different applications of the technology and many more that we haven't thought of that will come up in the future.
Right, because it's still early days, it sounds like.
Very early days. This is why it's a hot topic and a hot trend. Because it's a technology that's enabling all kinds of applications. And just like GPS or maps, I remember when they were first introduced 15 years ago, no one really understood how they would be used. And now they're ubiquitous. They're in all kinds of applications.
And we can't live without them.
Exactly. Yeah. The same is going to happen with indoor location. There are a few businesses and use cases that we can clearly understand, but there'll be hundreds more that will evolve that we just haven't thought of.
Right. So you mentioned there were a number of different technologies here at play. Will one of them become the standard in a couple of years?
Perhaps, but I don't think so. Because there are a variety of different ways to approach the problem. So Wi-Fi is one place, Bluetooth, lights in the ceiling, sound sensors, beacons. There are all these different technical approaches. They each have their advantages and disadvantages, and they sort of depend on cost of infrastructure versus low cost or accuracy. So if you want to be accurate to within 1 foot or 1 meter, those technologies are going to cost a little less than technologies that can do it within 3 meters or 10 meters. So there's a cost versus accuracy thing. There's also a open and ubiquitous versus private and proprietary. So some applications don't care about being open and ubiquitous. They're very specific applications for a retail store or for a venue or whatever. And there are others that care more about being open. So it depends. The short answer is no, I don't think that there will be one or two leaders. I think there'll be probably 20 different companies who will be successful in this area.
Wow, it'll be interesting to see how that shakes out over the next couple of years.
That's why it's a hot trend and a topic we need to talk about.
Hot trend and a topic we need to talk about. Good, thanks, Don. That's all for today. Thank you for joining us. If you have any questions you'd like us to bring up in future episodes, please leave them in the YouTube comments. Thank you for joining us and see you next week at the same time. Bye.